Hello everybody, welcome back to our channel talks. It has been a while since the last time we have heard news from Egosoft regarding the future of X4Found Ancients and the upcoming updates in 2019. A couple days ago, the developers have announced their plans for the game and some sorts of a roadmap that will guide us to X4's first expansion, logically sometime this year. So I would like to talk about the planned updates for X4Found Ancients today, but also discuss with you the Anthem VIP demo, the upcoming open demo, and the fears of microtransactions that have been growing lately. Before we begin though, please allow me to say hi and welcome everybody new to the channel and our channel talks. Channel Talk is our monthly series where we discuss our favorite games and share our thoughts. It is a great opportunity to communicate directly, for me to tell you what I think of certain news or share my plans for the future, and for you to tell me what you think of the latest news and give me your feedback. Welcome to the channel, welcome to our Channel Talks, and I am certain you will have a lot of fun with us here in our growing community. Now let's go ahead and start with Anthem. Last weekend we had the opportunity to test Anthem for the first time and the experience was bittersweet. I personally found the game rather enjoyable when I was able to connect and play. And this was the biggest issue with Anthem, too many technical issues. I have spent the entire first day of the demo on a loading screen, but the second day was much better, but there were still some issues like rubber banding and enemies disappearing. Gameplay wise, the game was what I'd expect a shooter looter to be. There was not much diversity and everything seemed the same and repetitive, but we cannot know if this was because of the game being like this, or because of the limited content in the demo. The customization options and the plethora of items and components to use in order to create different builds left me satisfied, I have to say, and I cannot wait to see more of it. Speaking of customization options, there has been a lot of talk lately about microtransactions and the price of cosmetics. This is because of a screen that was leaked showing two skins available for purchase at the price of $20 each, which is indeed quite expensive. I honestly do not care about skins and I will never buy any special for that price. The developers have said before that only cosmetic items with no impact on gameplay will ever be available like this, and so far it seems to be true. Of course, we will have to wait for the release of Anthem and some months after to see if they will stick to their words. My number one concern about Anthem has to do with progression and chance to drop viable items. Progression on the VIP demo felt rather slow, especially if we consider that it was adjusted in a way to help us experience more content faster than the actual released game. If after the release of Anthem players start complaining about not leveling fast enough or not dropping good weapons and items often, I'm afraid this could work as an excuse to introduce X% more experience or X% more chance to drop rare items packages to the game store, something that would kill the game for me and I guess many others. Either way, we will have to wait and see how things will evolve after the release of Anthem. Now let's talk about X4Found Ancients and its upcoming updates. We knew of 2.0, but Egosoft also announced two more updates, 2.5 and 3.0, that will lead us to the game's first expansion. 2.0 will come sometime in February and, as we already know, will give us the chance to build our own shipyards in-game, getting one step closer to actually creating a proper empire. 2.0 will also make crew training easier, giving purpose to our crew management. 2.5 will follow, unknown when, bringing a new ship type, resupply ships, with the intention to make them indispensable for fleets and military expeditions. Other improvements with 2.5 will include sector blacklist, telling your ships to avoid specific sectors so they don't die in vain, and better management of inventory items. Finally, 3.0 will allow us to better control sectors we own and set our own rules on them. Better combat missions that will combine with improved research in the player headquarters, and even moving the headquarters to a different location. 3.0 will also include at least one new game start. The first expansion of X4Found Ancients will come after the 3.0 update and will introduce the split rays to the game, along with their ships, stations, and a large new area of space. The developers will continue working on bug fixes and improving the game in between these updates, so hopefully by the time the first expansion is here, Most of the issues with X4 will be fixed and the game will work properly always. Last week I live streamed for the first time after a while. I thought showing Anthem to you directly will be the best way to understand the good and the bad things in this new upcoming title and help you decide whether to buy it or not. I love the experience and more than anything, discussing with you the issues and fun moments of Anthem. So this is something I'm planning to do again with many upcoming new titles or older games we have been covering and enjoying on the channel. I will stream Anthem again this weekend if there are no technical issues preventing me from doing so, and I am curious to see how much different and hopefully better the open demo will be from the VIP demo. Of course, I would love to see you all there and chat about the game. I would love to hear your thoughts on the microtransactions issue with Anthem lately, but also what you would like to see more in the upcoming X4 Foundations updates. Finally, I would like to thank you all for your support and love you're showing to me and the channel. You are amazing and the reason I keep doing what I am doing, and I am having fun doing it. Thank you all, I am Squid of Love and I will see you next time. Bye bye.